Begin a sketch on the right plane. You will be sketching a profile for the revolve of the main body. Start with a horizontal line from the origin and a vertical line down. Set the vertical line to be construction and set the horizontal line to be a center line. This will be the axis for the revolve. From the origin, draw another two lines perpendicular to each other. Begin a tangent arc. Snap one end of the tangent arc to this point. The arc would automatically be tangent to the vertical line. Draw another tangent arc to join with this arc. Close the profile with a spline. Make the spline tangent at these two points. Define the location of this spline point. Define the length of the spline handles. For this spline handle, dimension it parallel to the handle. Lastly, define the radii of these two arcs. Confirm the sketch and begin the revolve command. Because of the existence of the center line, both the axis and the profile have been automatically selected. Make a circle sketch on this face. Begin the extrude command. Drag to select the two profiles and extrude to a distance of 5 mm. Add a 1 mm fillet to these two edges. To add a fillet of a different value within the same command, click on the plus sign and select this edge, and add a 3 mm fillet here. Now we shall proceed to cut out the thumb or finger recess. Begin a sketch on the right plane. Go to Create, Project Include, Intersect. Select these two faces. This will create projected lines which are a result of the intersection between the sketch plane and the faces. Go to the sketch palette and click on Look At to view normal to the sketch plane. Sketch a three-point arc. Dimension these two points with respect to the origin. Begin the extrude command. We shall perform a symmetrical cut through all. Add a 1 mm fillet. Begin a circular pattern. Set type to features. Go to the timeline and select the extruder cut and the fillet. For axis, select the Z-axis. Set the quantity to 3. At this point, we want to create two copies of the body. In the past, I have been using a simple copy and paste. Let's try using the boundary fill command. Go to Create, Boundary Fill. Select the body as a tool. Click on the select box and select this cell. The command recognizes an enclosed region within the surface of the body and fills up that space, creating an exact copy. I want to thank Peter for recommending this method for copying bodies. Let's rename the bodies. Hide the first copy. perform another boundary fill on the original to get a second copy. Hide the second copy also. As we move along, it will become evident why we have to produce two copies of the body. Next, we need to isolate the region of the body for making the pattern. The pattern is at an angle to the primary planes. Go to Construct, Plane at Angle. Select the Z-axis and set the angle. Begin a sketch on this new plane. Make a center-to-center slot. Set a horizontal constraint between the origin and this point. Dimension from the origin as follows. Confirm the sketch. Go to Modify, Split Body. Select the original body as a body to split. Select the sketch as the splitting tool. We do not have any use for the excess. Right-click on the body and remove. Next, we shall create a seed extrude. Begin another sketch on an angle plane. This will be a circle. Set a horizontal constraint between the origin and a center point. Draw a horizontal line from the center. Convert this to a center line. Draw a 45-degree line from the center. Convert this to contraction. Mirror this across the center line. These will be the directions for performing the staggered pattern. Begin the extrude command with this circle as a profile. For extent type, choose Tool Object and select the body from the Bodies folder as the object. Set the operation to Join. Adjust the offset. This creates a cylindrical extrude that takes reference from the underlying face. I would recommend to perform a save at this point. To achieve a staggered pattern, let's perform a rectangular pattern in two directions. For type, change to Features and select the extrude. For directions, click on the select box. Go to the circle sketch and pick on the two 45-degree construction lines. For distance type, set to spacing. Adjust the quantity and distance. Doing a full pattern here would really slow down the subsequent steps, so I would recommend to do a limited pattern for the moment. After the full handle is created, you can always come back to adjust the quantity. For compute option, set to adjust. Next, perform a shell. With the tangent chain option checked, select the chain of faces on the side, followed by the bottom faces. Adjust the thickness. This piece will actually form part of the overmold of the handle. Think of it as a rubber sheath surrounding the handle. This is why the shell is needed. The face underlying the pattern is slightly recessed. Go to Modify, Offset Face. Select this face and adjust the offset. The adjacent tangent face will be offset by the same amount. Let's rename this and hide the body for the moment. Bring back the first copy. We will be working on the rest of the overmold. Go to Modify, Split Face. Select these two faces to split. Bring back the slot sketch that was used to define the pattern region and use that as a splitting tool. Let's mirror this across the right plane. Set Type to Features and select the Split Face feature from the timeline. Use the right plane as a mirror plane. Create a sketch on the right plane. Create a slot sketch to define this region. Add a horizontal constraint between the origin and this point. Dimension from the origin. Confirm the sketch. Begin a split face command. Select these faces to split. And select the new slot sketch as the splitting tool. Begin a sketch on this face and create a hexagon. Set this edge to vertical. Use this hexagonal sketch to split this face. Let's take a look at the final result of the overmold. It is basically a hollow body with openings. We shall perform a shell by defining regions where we need the body to open up. The command will do the rest and remove material internally to create a consistent thickness all around. Begin the shell command. Uncheck the tangent chain option. Select these faces to open up. Including the dome at the end. Adjust the thickness. Bring back the pattern body. We are going to create duplicates of the pattern body to slot into these openings. Begin the mirror command. Set the type to bodies and select the pattern body. Set the right plane as a mirror plane. Perform another mirror to mirror these two bodies across the top plane. Go to Modify, Combine. Select all the bodies in the Bodies folder and combine them into one. This is a complete overmold body. Bring back copy 2. Copy 2 would obviously overlap with the overmold body. We shall use the overmold body to cut into copy 2 to create the recess necessary to accommodate the overmold. Begin the combine command. Select the copy as a target body. Select the overmold as a tool body. Set the operation to cut. Check on the Keep Tools option as we still need to retain the overmold after the operation. Because of the recessed face underlying the pattern, there will be these slivers of material left over. Select all these bodies and remove them. If we hide the overmold, we cannot see the recess created on the underlying substrate. Let's create clearances between the overmold and the substrate. Go to Modify, Offset Face. For faces that are tangent to each other, you only need to select one face. You can select multiple faces in the same command. In the case of the hexagon, since the faces are not tangent to each other, you will have to select all the faces. This will pull back on the faces to create the clearance. The handle is now complete. I would recommend to perform a save at this point. You can go back into the rectangular pattern and adjust the quantity. After confirming, it will take some time to regenerate.